Computer program to sort an array in ascending order. In order to present the array elements in ascending or descending order, what logic we have to use? Just assume that we have some numbers. Say we have 2, 3, 1, 5, 8 here. We want the result to be like this. 1, 2, and then 3 and 5 and 8. So this is the ascending order. For that, we need an array. So let us say we have an array. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 members are there. We'll start with here with a variable, say I. And this will be, first is 0. So this will be A0. Then now we'll compare this, we'll fix it. And we'll compare this with each others in the or which are coming after this value in the array. Say this is A1. So if this is I, we start with J, but J is I plus 1 because this is 0, this is 1. So if I is 0, J has to be I plus 1, that is 1. Now we'll compare them. So 2 is greater than 3 or not. We see that 2 is not greater than 3, it is less than 3. So we'll do nothing. We'll do nothing. Now 3 is done. We have to compare 2 with 2, 2 with 1 now. Now 2 is greater than 1. And in order to have it ascending, because this condition holds now, is true, we will try to swap these two. We'll swap these two. So how to swap this? Say this is A0 and this is A1, A2, 0, 1, 2. So A0 and A2 we have to swap. So let us take a temporary variable. So this is having 2 and this is having 1. So put this value in temporary variable. So that is A0 into temporary variable. Now put, now A0, this T has 2 now. Now put this A2 in A0. So now we have put this 1 here. So now A0 is having 1. Now temporary has 2. So now put this temporary in this A2. So this A2 will have now 2. So this is swapping. So this is what we have to do. If this condition doesn't hold, then you have to keep it like this. Otherwise, you have to swap. Now once this is done, you will get 1 here and 2 here. So we will compare again with this 5, 2 with 5 and 8 with 5, etc. So for one iteration, one go, you will have one value at its precise position. Then now we will increment I here. Now I will be here. Now J will be, of course, I plus 1. Now this J will be, again, I is fixed now for this member. Now we will not take this value. Now we will compare 3 with other members, like 3 with 2, 3 with 5, 3 with 8. So 3 and 2 we'll compare, and we see that 3 and 2, 3 is greater than 2. So 2 will come here, 3 will come here. We have to swap. And this is how this goes on. So here is a program. Even if you want to write in C, C++, Java, you just have to change these things, like hash include iostream for C++. For C, it will be hash include stdio.h and conio.h. We'll start with the hash define max equal to 100. Why this we have done? See, we have an array. As we said, that we have to have an array. Now, this array can have some maximum size, that the size of the array has to be defined. Now, we have certain variable. I'll just come to this. First, we'll ask the user to enter the total number of elements to read, how many numbers he wants in the array. So, he says n. Now, we have to check the bound. The array size is only 100. So if he goes below, this n is below 0, that is, say he gives minus 13. This is not acceptable. Say he gives 130. That is not also acceptable. He has to give between 1 and 100. Otherwise, we'll just check the bound and say return minus 1. That this is not a valid range. He has to give in between this. So this is bounding check, very important. Now read the elements now from 0 to n minus 1, 0 to n minus 1, that is I, 0 to I less than n. This is I variable. So we have n variable and I variable. We'll use j also. This array is for the values which are going to keep it, we keep inside. And this temporary temp for the temporary variable for swapping. Now here we have entered the element. Now we are showing I plus 1. Why? Because we can't show the user enter element 0. We cannot show him. The first element should be first because the array starts from 0. So we have to add a 1 here. Now see in ARR, so how many numbers he wants to enter, he will enter here. Now it's always a good idea to show the user what he has entered. That will be the unsorted array elements. From I equal to 0, I less than n, just print these array, because this is an for printing and for getting an array you need to have a loop. So this is a for loop for showing the array. You can have a slash t tab, so all the values will come with a tab in between. Now our actual logic starts here. See, we'll start with I equal to 0, I less than n. So this is your first loop. This loop is I equal to 0, so I starts from here for the first element. Now when it goes inside, j is equal to I plus 1, j will be this one. So if I equal to this value, j will be equal to I plus 1. So we have to compare, say 2, 1, 3, 8 is here. We have to compare 2 with 1. We cannot compare 2 with 2. So we cannot have j equal to 0 also. We have to have j, if we have to compare, say one first element is done, then we have to compare this element with this one. So that is why j equal to always I plus 1. Whatever I will be there, j will be 1 added to j will be 1 added to I. Then we have comparison. So when we compare, that is if ARRI is greater than ARRJ, that is this element is either greater or less than. So if it is greater, we'll swap them. I already told you how to swap them. And then this will go on and on, this one, till the end of arrays has been reached. Now after this, we come again. Now this has been done. I will be here, J plus 1 will be here. And this j will again go till the end of the array and compare it with this one. Again, this will be done. I will be here, j plus 1. So this will go on. And finally, this array will be sorted. And this kind of sorting is known as bubble sorting. Now finally, you can just print this array, the sorted array, by the same logic here. Just I equal to 0 to n, c out, ARRI, and just print it and return 0.